Hello friends, this is Praveen Pawar. In this video, we are going to discuss a question paper of UGC NET July 2018. This is paper 2 of Electronic Science. Here, we will discuss from question number 21 to 40. For rest of the questions, please find the playlist available on my YouTube channel Praveen2548. Now, here we start. Our first question is, in JFH, the maximum value of transconductance GM is? This direct expression is given in option 2, 2IDSS upon VP. So, correct option is 2. Next question is, the cutoff frequency of TEM transverse electromagnetic wave is? Its correct option is 1. Cutoff frequency of TEM wave is 0. Question number 23. Limiter circuit is not needed in the following detector. Foster Seeley discriminator, balanced slope, ratio detector, none. All these three are AM receivers and the limiter circuit is not needed in the ratio detector. Third one is the correct answer. Question number 24. Which of the following is used to analyze all kind of matters? Here, spectrophotometers. Spectrophotometers is the quantitative measurement of the reflection or transmission properties of a material as a function of wavelength. So, this is not the option. Electron microscope is a microscope that uses a beam of electrons to create an image of the specimen. This is also not the correct option. X-ray diffractometer is a measuring instrument for analyzing the structure of a material. So this is our correct option. X-ray diffractometer is used to analyze all kind of matters. The third one is our correct option. And last, spectrum analyzer measures the magnitude of an input signal versus frequency within the full frequency range of the instrument. Spectrum analyzer to analyze the characteristic of the signals. So this is also not the option. So, X-ray diffractometer is the correct option for the question 24. Next question is, in a silicon oxidation model, if Hg is gas phase mass transfer coefficient, Cg is the oxidant concentration in the bulk of the gas, and Cs is the oxidant concentration adjacent to the oxide surface, then for a steady state, the gas phase flux can be expressed as? So its correct expression is Hg into Cg minus Cs. So this C is correct. Here we will see in the options. A in C are correct. This is not the option. B is correct. C is correct but A is wrong. So third one is our correct option. Now question number 26. When acceptor impurities of concentration Na are added to a semiconductor crystal, when N is electron density in the conduction band and P is the hole density in the valence band, the ionized acceptors are given as? So here direct expression is given in option A. So A is correct. Na upon 1 plus 4 exponential of Ea minus Ef upon kT, where this 4 is a degeneracy factor which has the constant value of 4. And Ea is the acceptor energy level and F is the Fermi energy level. So here A is our correct one. So A is correct but C is wrong. We will choose the option number 2 for the question number 26. Now question number 27. Which of the following statements are correct for A to D analog to digital converters? The advantage of using a dual slope A to D converter in a digital voltmeter is that its accuracy is high. So this is correct. The number of comparators in A to D flash in a 4-bit flash A to D converters is 15. This is also correct. The number of comparators is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1, where n is equal to number of bits. So here 2 to the power 4 minus 1 is 15. So this is also correct. The minimum number of comparators required to build an 8-bit flash A to D converter is? For 8-bit flash A to D converter, it is not 256, it should be 255. The number of comparators required in a 3-bit comparator type A2D converter is 8. So this should be 7. So both C and D are wrong. Only A and B are correct. So we will choose option 3. Now question number 28. Which of the following statements are correct? CMOS has higher speed and smaller power than BJT. This first statement is wrong, because BJT is used for high speed switching. So BJT has the higher speed than CMOS. So this is wrong. CMOS ICs inputs should never be left unconnected as it may damage the device. This is correct. CMOS ICs with symmetrical inputs are useful for better noise immunity. This is also correct. CMOS is most popular logic family in VLSI technology. This is also correct. So B, C and D are correct. Second one is our correct option. Question number 29. Which of the following statements are correct in respect of 8086 microprocessor? The instruction queue size is 8 bytes. So here this is not 8 bytes, this is 6 bytes. So why? Because the maximum instruction size in 8086 is of 6 byte. So for this, the instruction queue requires maximum 6 bytes size. So this statement is wrong. The segment register size is 16 bit while physical address size is 20 bits. This is 16 bit microprocessor because it has 16 bit data lines, but it has 20 bit address lines. So this statement is correct. Segments are disjoint. This is not correct. Beginning address of a segment must be divisible by 16. So this is also correct because it has the segment addressing, and segment addressing is used where available memory is divided into chunks called the segments. So correct answer is here B and D are correct. Second one is our correct option. Now question number 30. What happens when RET statement is executed in 8085 microprocessor? RET is for return statement. When in our main routine call function is executed, it calls the another subroutine. So in the subroutine, in the last, we will have to write return. So our program will return to the main routine, which is written next to the call instruction. So here RET statement is executed in 8085 processor. Program counter is clear. Control is transferred from the subroutine to the main program. Returning address is loaded into the accumulator. Returning address is loaded into the program counter from the top of the stack. So we will have to choose the correct answer. So B and D are correct. So we'll choose option 2. Question number 31. If A is declared as one dimensional array in C, then asterisk or pointer A plus I is same as asterisk ampersand A of I. This is correct. Asterisk A plus I is same as asterisk A plus I. So this is wrong statement here. Ampersand of A is same as A plus I, not minus 1. So this also wrong. Asterisk A plus I is same as A of I. This is also correct. Which of the above statements are incorrect? We have to choose the incorrect statement. Here B and C are incorrect. So we will choose option 3. 3 is the correct answer for this question number 31. Now question number 32. Which of the following specifiers in C++ need not be honored by the compiler? Static, inline, external, register. Which of the following is correct? So correct is inline and register. So B and D are correct. First one is the correct answer option. Question number 33. Which of the following statements are true in case of pulse code modulation PCM? If the number of bits per sample is increased from n to n plus 1, the signal to noise ratio S upon NQ ratio would be 6 dB. So this statement is correct. The quantization noise depends on sampling rate. This is not correct. No, the quantization noise is given as del square upon 12, where this del is the quantization step size. It does not depend on the sampling rate. The main advantage of PCM is that it possesses better performance in presence of noise. This is correct. If the number of quantization levels increases from 4 to 64, the bandwidth increases by a factor of 4. So this is not correct. A and C are correct only. Second one is the correct option. Question number 34. The following statements are correct for DSB-SC signal. DSB-SC is known as double sideband suppressed carrier transmission. This figure shows the characteristic of the DSB-SC. It is a low pass filter. This is correct. It needs minimum transmitted power. So SSB, single sideband sophisticated, where one sideband is also suppressed. It takes the less power than DSBSC. So we cannot say it needs minimum transmitted power. So this is not correct. It is a result of product modulator. Here balancer or product modulator is used. So this is correct. Bandwidth of DSBSC is twice the maximum frequency. So this is also correct. This is the input signal where it has the bandwidth FM. So after modulation, this is our carrier frequency. This is would be FC plus FM, and this would be FC minus FM. So now the bandwidth of the modulated signal would be FC plus FM minus FC minus of FC minus FM. So it would be twice of FM. So here A, C and D are correct. Fourth one is the correct answer. Question number 35. In an abrupt PN junction of NA is very very less than ND, then the barrier potential is, and we know that the barrier potential is given as E upon 2 epsilon omega naught square NND upon NA plus ND. When NA is very very less than ND, so this denominator would be equivalent to ND. ND and ND would be cancelled out and only NA will remain. So here it matches with the option B. So B is correct, but D is wrong. Second one would be the correct answer. Here this W is known as depletion width. Now question number 36. In a voltage series feedback amplifier with load RL, if RI is the input resistance without feedback, then the input resistance with feedback is. So from the expression directly we can say the correct expression for this, it would be RI upon 1 plus beta AV. Here A and C are correct, this cannot be the answer. A and D are wrong, this cannot be the answer. C and A are wrong, this cannot be the answer. Only B and D are wrong. So here for this question we will choose option 2 as a correct answer for this question 36. Now question number 37. Magnetron is a O type tube, a low power device, high power device, an oscillator. There are two types, O type and M type. Magnetron is a M type tube, not O type. So this is incorrect. A low power device, this is also incorrect. This is a high power device. So C is correct and D is correct. Third one is our correct option. Here I would like to show you the comparison between O and M type tubes. Example of O type tubes are Klystron, LXTWT, BWN, BWO. There, on the other hand, M type tubes are magnetrons, emitron, gyrotrons, etc. Now question number 38. A traveling wave tube amplifier has the following properties. It provides an octave bandwidth. It provides an approximate gain of 40 dB and more. It has a low noise figure. It has a very high noise figure. It has low noise figure. So C is correct and D is wrong. And A and B both are also correct. So A, B and C only are the correct statements. So fourth one is our correct answer. Question number 39. The block diagram of a feedback compensated system is given below. So here block diagram is given. Which of the following statements are correct? When KT is equal to 0, so if this term would be 0, there would be unity feedback. The feedback compensation is ineffective and the system is uncompensated. So this statement is correct. When KT is equal to 0, the feedback compensation is most effective and system is compensated. This is not correct. The performance of the compensated system depends on KT and T. This is correct. The performance of compensated system does not depend on T. This is not correct. So A and C are correct. First one would be the correct option. Question number 40. The capacitor microphone is most widely used for precision measurements because it has good frequency response, excellent linearity, large dynamic pressure range. Which of the above are correct? So here you see all three are correct statements. So here the correct answer for this question would be A, B and C. Fourth is the correct option for this. So that's all about for this video. For rest of the questions, please find the playlist available on my YouTube channel Praveen5488. In the last, I would like to say thanks. Thanks for your kind attention. All your all suggestions are most welcome. Please like, share and comment and subscribe my channel Praveen5488. All the best friends. Thank you very much.